In this video, I'm talking about these Wago, I think that's how you pronounce it, wire nut alternatives, and they are amazing. I have not used a wire nut since. I never used wire nuts correctly anyway, but in this video, I'm going to tell you all about these things and also how I messed up the wire nuts. So you buy these in little packets of different numbers of wires, and so these are both actually two wire connections, one that's straight and one that is kind of parallel. Typically, you have one that has, this one has five different wires that can go into it. And what I like about this is it's so incredibly simple. These will work from gauge 12 gauge wire to 24 gauge wire. So it's got a really big span of what it works with versus like working with wire nuts. Like you had like all different sizes of wire nuts for the different sizes of wire. And then you needed to know how many wires are going in with what gauge to figure out which wire nut. With these, as long as you're between 12 gauge and 24 gauge, which is a lot of wiring, this is going to work just fine. So you just decide when you buy a pack how many of each size you want. And I think you could probably get them in any singular size too, but I always buy the packs. And they'll also work with stranded wire or solid wire. So really flexible. And like I said, you just choose the one that is according to how many wires you need to splice together. To operate them is pretty simple. You just flip up whichever one you're gonna put a wire in, and then you put the wire in from that side. Let me show you some of those gauges
here.
So almost, it'll actually go thinner than this.
Two wires, three wires, and five wires.
You see it touch the back, and then you just flip it down. And you can see it's clamped in there pretty tight, which is amazing because it works with all the different sizes of wires. And you can actually see the wire in there also. So that's one of the beauties of these is you know if the wire is properly put in there by looking inside. So no need to be putting black electrical tape over these. Also, it says there's a guide on the side for how long you should strip the wire, and it's 11 millimeters. And it's only on one of the short sides, but it's really hard to see. So pretty much what I say is just go with the guide of from the end of the plastic to the end of the metal, and that'll be the right size. And you want to be sure that the insulation goes into this inside the plastic. You don't want the bare wire to be hanging out outside here. The insulation needs to be inside the clear plastic area. So another feature, I didn't even know this had this feature, is the ability to test these. So let's see, let me take this off and I'll show you how to test it. So each one of these has one spot where you can test it, and you'll see it's actually the one with the Wago logo on it. And so you just go to the end and you can see that it has continuity. It only, like I said, it's in one spot. So same thing, if you were to do one of the bigger ones, you can see it's the one with the Wago logo in it. It will go in. Of course, this one's not connected, but the other ones don't have that spot. If you're working with one of the straight through ones, that spot's actually gonna be in the middle here. There it is. So that one's a little more obvious because it's in the middle. And if that wasn't enough of an explanation, it comes with a little instruction sheet too. So I never used these correctly. Let me show you what I was always doing wrong outside of like not knowing which one to use. With these, when you wire two wires together, you actually, according to code, have to wire it past the point where the wires are clamped in there to the point where the area that still has insulation on it is twisted together. So this is what it's supposed to look like. And I never did that. I always would just wire it twisted together until it felt good, pull on it maybe, but this is the right way to do it. And then if you have to rewire something, it's a pain in the butt to use one of these older connections. With these, you can always just flip it open, pull the wire out. With these, just super simple. It's almost impossible to do it wrong, almost.